Hi, I'm Marshall from Gardona Vapes. In this video, we're going to talk about the recipe for the Mistress. This is a nice fruit salad vape, my favorite summer vape. The dominant notes are kiwi, pomegranate, and honeydew, and it has a light cream vanilla base that keeps things from getting too fruity and out of hand. The first flavor in it is Flavor Art Kiwi. This is a wonderful flavor. It's one of my favorite fruit flavors. It tastes just like an authentic kiwi to me. It has that nice tartness that you get out of kiwi, along with the bright green notes that come along with it. This is a base that I'll oftentimes use as a starting flavor that I'll then put other fruits in with just to see how they work with it. And you can also use it in small amounts to help other flavors come out in a mix. The next flavor is Flavor Art Pomegranate. This is a great pomegranate flavor. It's personally my favorite of all the pomegranates that I've tried. It can be a little bit pungent if you go too high with it in a recipe, but as long as you keep it fairly low, it's a nice red flavor that has some more earthy notes to it that you don't get out of Flavor Art Kiwi. The next flavor is Flavor Art Vanilla Tahiti. This is the base for the cream in the recipe, and I really like to use this flavor with fruits because it's not a strong custard vanilla. It's a fairly light vanilla with a little bit of a nutty element to it. That nutty element helps to keep fruit flavors a little bit grounded and round out the body of that vape. A lot of the times I'll find that when using just fruit flavors, they can often become very candy-like or very perfume-like. Using something like Vanilla Tahiti that brings in a little bit of vanilla and a little bit of nuttiness helps to ground the recipe while not turning it into a full-fledged bakery recipe. The next flavor is Flavor Art Coconut. The coconut in this flavor is not designed to give a coconut flavor to the recipe, but instead it's supposed to bring out the creaminess in the vanilla. Now, I personally don't respond to coconut very strongly, so I tend to use more than a lot of people probably would. You might want to lower the amount of coconut in this recipe to the point where you just start to get a little bit of creaminess and the vanilla pops a little bit more. But not everybody's gonna like it as high as I have it. I personally can't taste the coconut in this recipe, but if you can taste it and don't like it, just try having it a couple times and see how that works for you. The next flavor is TFA Honeydew. This is a great flavor. It's my go-to melon flavor. Where a lot of watermelon flavors are very artificial and taste more like a watermelon Airhead or something along those lines, TFA Honeydew is, in small amounts, pretty much to my taste, exactly like an actual honeydew. You don't want to use it at high percentages because it very quickly will become cloying and sickly sweet. Unless you're a nut about honeydew, then you might want to try using it at higher percentages in some kind of a honeydew candy kind of recipe. Thanks for watching. I hope that if you think the recipe looks good, that you'll take the time to mix it up and let me know what you think about it in the comments. Whether you mix up this recipe or you mix up something else, I hope that you'll DIY your own e-liquid and make sure that the FDA doesn't take away our ability to vape.